Hey guys, and welcome back to Captain Zahid. A few days ago, I shared a few photos of Holland and Denmark on Instagram. While the photos were actually looking nice and beautiful, the thing that caught everyone's eye was the time of the day the photo was taken. One was taken at around 10 o'clock at night, and the other was taken just before the sunset. That was around 10:30 or something. There were quite a few comments simply asking why the sun was not setting here, or why would it set so late? And if you guys still see behind me, you can still see the twilight. And it will remain like that throughout the night until the sun rises. There will be no complete darkness. Well, the thing is that it all starts with the Earth and its shape. The role of the sun in all of this is not so much. The Earth is not exactly round like this ball. It actually is bulged out near the equator. Then the Earth revolves on its axis and completes one revolution in just tad less than 24 hours. But one important feature of the Earth is that it is tilted on its axis to about 23.5 degrees. The Earth keeps spinning on its axis and keeps revolving around the Sun. This means that at one point of year, the northern half of the Earth is closer to the Sun, and the other time, the southern half of the Earth is closer to the Sun. When northern half or northern hemisphere is close to the Sun, it is northern summers, like right now. And at the same time, it's winters in the southern half or the southern hemisphere. 6 months later, the situation changes, and the northern hemisphere moves away from the sun, and the southern hemisphere closes in. This means the summer in southern hemisphere, like Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, and Southern America, and winters here in the northern part. During all of this, twice a year, the Earth is in such a position that the sun illuminates northern and southern hemispheres equally. This is called as equinox. It happens on 20th of March and then 22nd of September. This makes the start of the spring or the autumn, depending upon which part of the world you're living in. Similarly, as I explained just moments ago, on 21st of June, the northern hemisphere is closest to the sun, making that as the longest day in the northern hemisphere, but the shortest day in the southern hemisphere. On 21st of December, though, these fates are reversed. It's the longest day of year in the southern hemisphere and the shortest day in the northern hemisphere. By the way, the dates each year can change by one day because the Earth doesn't actually complete one round around the sun in 365 days. It's actually 365.24 days to be exact. That is why there is a leap year in every 4 years to compensate for these 0.24 days. And then there is a leap century to compensate for the overcompensation that we have already done every 4 years. Anyway, coming back to the topic, you guys have already noticed one thing, that days become longer in summers and shorter in winters. And the reason is this phenomena that I just explained a few moments ago. Now, add one more fact to all of this. Sun is our only source of light, and it is so big that 1.3 million Earths can fit inside our sun. The light coming from this huge source is falling relatively straight on and the areas near the equator. But as the Earth curves close to the poles, the angles at which this light falls over these areas becomes shallow. Okay, now, consider this as the sun. This source of light is falling on the Earth. The Earth is 23.5 degrees tilted on its axis. This is the northern hemisphere, and this part below this line is the southern hemisphere. Now, in the northern summers, what happens is that northern part is close to the sun. The rays are falling directly almost on the equator, but due to this curvature of Earth, the rays have a shallow angle when they are falling over here, that is near the poles. Observe one thing when I rotate this ball. The Earth spins around its axis, and that is how the day and night changes. But notice one thing, the light is always falling here, while the days are changing near the equator, a little bit to the north, a little bit to the south as well. This side is completely dark, this side is illuminated, but even when I am revolving it and spinning it around its axis, this portion, that is the North Pole, it is always illuminated. This is the position of Earth when it is summer solstice, when the northern part is close to the sun. After revolving around the sun for 6 months, now the situation is completely reversed. Now southern part is close to the sun, while northern part is away from the sun. Notice one thing now. The northern pole is not illuminated at all, while the southern pole, it is illuminated 24 hours, doesn't matter how much you revolve the Earth. And this is a position of winter solstice. That means that in northern part of the world, it is winter right now. And in southern part of the world, it is summer right now. Now, I think it should be very clear in the mind of everyone that why, due to this rotation of Earth, it's tilted on its axis of 23.5 degrees. The seasons change, the duration of the day change, and why the days are longer in northern hemisphere in summers and shorter in winters. The result of all of this is this phenomena that you guys already know of. Days becoming longer in summers and shorter in winters. This phenomena keeps amplifying as you keep going to higher or northern or southern latitudes. Due to this curvature of the Earth, the sun remains visible for a longer duration in northern latitudes in summers and for shorter duration in winters. This phenomena is amplified so much at the poles that around the time of summer solstice, the sun never sets. It takes a round in the sky only. And in the summer atmosphere, it never rises at all. At the time of winter solstice, the fate changes. And while the sun never sets in the South Pole, it never rises on the North Pole. And that is precisely the reason that even here, where we are right now, there is always some light now. Now, as I've switched on my camera light and the ship's light are also on, and you may not be able to see the twilight, but I hope you do.
As an example, just observe this time lapse that I made near the coast of Denmark, and you can clearly see that sun will just go down below the horizon and it will rise again. There will be no real darkness.
Today we have sunset at 21:25 and sunrise at 4:32 a.m. Technically, the sun doesn't go below 16 degrees off the horizon, and there is no real darkness at all. And by the way, it is a combination of this Earth's tilt to 23.5 degrees, the summer equinox, the summer solstice, winter equinox, and winter solstice that the seasons change. If it were not for this phenomena, there would be no seasons at all. Had it not been for this, some parts of the world will always have summers and some part of the world would always have winters. And certain crops will always grow only in certain parts of the world. And if the seasons wouldn't change, then some rivers wouldn't flow at all. You guys can very well understand how the things will become if the seasons won't change at all. I sincerely hope that I was able to highlight the point and make you people understand why the days are longer here. If you knew all of this already, but you still chose to watch my video, then thanks a lot. But if you didn't know this before, then now you do. And finally, if you guys think that I missed something here, then please do mention that in the comment section. And also let me know about your views in the comment section. Do check out more videos on my channel, and I hope you'll find them useful. If you found this video useful or liked it anyway, then don't forget to give the video a like, share it with your friends, and consider subscribing to my channel. With tons of love for my digital family and to be digital family, this is me, Zahid Nisar. You are watching Captain Zahid, and until the next video, bye.